Hey, welcome back to Skyrim, everybody. This is Provolone, and I have some good news and bad news. Good news is I look pretty freaking creepy. The bad news is, let me pause right here. The bad news is, I did a lot of recording, a lot, because I got so into the game. I thought, you know what? Let's record it all. That way, I can make snippets and do whatever needs to be done. And what happened was, my computer needed some updates, and I was like, oh yeah, no big deal. Computer needs updates, no big deal. Well, I realized that when I was cleaning up stuff too, the recordings I did didn't capture the video, only captured the audio. Now, this is episode 5, and I pre-recorded 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I did a lot, let's just leave it at that. And they all didn't capture video. They were broken up quality. So they were just horrible. There would be no point into working on them. Not at all. So let me just quickly, as best I can, give you an update. So you may notice that I have new armor and new things. Well, to go basically off of what just happened, when I went back to Whiterun after the episode, I got attacked by some people called cultists. Now, to me, I've never seen them before in the Skyrim game when I played on the PS3. And basically what happened is they attacked me. They had orders to attack me. So at the same time, I made my way back to here, and I talked to somebody else, a lady from the Blades. And if you know anything about Skyrim, the Blades are people who used to kill dragons back in the day, and they were pretty cool warriors. So I was on my way to doing a mission for her, and I was like, well, you know what, this is where the cultists said their ship would be, let's go over there. And to make a long story short, I entered into a new territory. Let's go to my map. We'll just do this. Sulthium. Yeah, we went to a place called Sulthium. That's a mouthful for me. Don't ask me to say it again. We'll call it Sol for short. So we went to Sol. And it was a completely different thing. Because when I played the PS3, I've never, ever, ever, ever been to this place. Seen it before. So I'll give a quick little tour of everything. But basically, long story short, we get here. They don't like us because I'm an outsider. I'm from Skyrim. This is a completely different place. I think it's called Morrowind is what properly by. And long story short, let me back up. We did a lot of things. We went to a lot of places. I've been to basically everything on this map. And I'll give you some brief details, and I'll go to the places to show you. But there's these places called Stones. And basically, long story short, these cultists were ordered to kill me by a person called Marowak. And Marowak was a dragonborn before me, and he was planning on controlling over the world and controlling people. So we had these stones, and he bent the wills of people, mind control them to building these things. And a lot of people were like, why are my friends and family building this thing? It's pointless, it's stupid. And well, yeah, no doubt, stupid. So basically, after going to this and doing some other missions, we found out that there's a group of people that have been trying to fight Marowak. They're called the Skull. So let's go to the Skull Village. And the Skull are a bunch of Nords who live in the more frozen, wintry part of this place. So basically, they're like, yeah, we've been trying to fight and all that. And this is where I met Freya. So, and I'll explain Freya in a second, but let me go back. So long story short, we basically help them out, and they're like, alright, the only way to defeat him is to find out why Marowak is doing what he's doing and to get the same powers as Marowak. Mirok's not Marowak. I'm thinking of Pokemon, sorry. So basically, long story short, there's a thing called Black Books, and I'll show you in my items. Books. See, Black Books, and they're pretty dark, pretty creepy looking, and each one has some pretty strong monsters that you have to fight through and all this other stuff, and you have to go through the end and get perks. This whole thing is, the dragonborn before me, Mirok, he has the power of the god from this thing. He's an evil god, And so basically the only way for me to defeat him would be having the same powers as him, which means reading these books, going through all that, and fighting him. So after doing a lot of that, I finally basically submitted, said, okay, I'll do this. And the evil god was like, all right, well, you got to give me the secrets from the skull. So we went to the skull, talked to the head leader. He said he'd reveal the secrets, and he sacrificed himself so we could do so. I learned the last word. I had to find a dragon. I think the dragon was over here anyway. So I had to find a dragon over here and kill it, gain its power, unlock the thing, read the book, Waking Dreams, which is one of the dark books, and then go and kill Mirok. Now, there's a lot of other things that happen too. So basically, this place, Ravenrock, which I do have a home with, was being attacked by these people called the Ash People, being controlled by an Imperial guy who apparently, I think, never died 200 years ago. So I had to kill the Ash People to do that. Down here, I paid a guy who was trying to summon another guy, and he didn't tell me, but he said he was an excavator. We'd make a bunch of money, so I kept paying him money to do that. People kept killed. I kept finding cool things. Let's see. Smart wizard dude over here. Helped him out for a little bit. And what I did was, when you had the bend the will shout, you had to clear the stones. And this is the temple of him, of Mirok. What else can I explain that won't waste a bunch of time? The tiny dudes. Okay, so there's these people in this village, and I'll go over there. And long story short, they're cool little dwarf people. Troll, little tiny troll people. Yeah, I would say troll. These little blue dudes. I call them the angry, swollen Smurfs. And so I didn't know this, but there was two ways you could have done this mission. You could have gone into here and helped them out by defeating some Nords, some of your people, or you could have went down here, helped the Nords to defeat them. Well, I didn't think about it through, and I just, you know, me just trying to get it through everything, I was like, oh, look, a mission. Did the mission, then I realized later on, doing some research, oh, I could have done this. It made Nord friends, and yeah, no, that didn't happen. But now I became a king of them. I'm the king of these people, and when I fight in areas like this, they actually, look at them. They're so cute. They're creepy, but cute. But when I fight, sometimes you'll see them pop up out of nowhere, throwing their spears and all that. So that's pretty cool. Let's see, what else can I think of? Werebears. You know how the story of people with werewolves there? They have to, by this moonlight, they turn into werewolves, or people attacking, they turn into werewolves. Same thing here, but instead of werewolves, they're bears. They're stronger, much more deadlier, and I had to fight a lot of them, and it was really pissing me off. Let's see. Stall room. Oh, yeah, so the helmet. The helmet is a special addition for this. Oh, I also forgot to mention, this is, so the area I'm in apparently is a DLC, a downloadable content, but since I bought the special edition and paid the money for it, I guess it came with it. I didn't know that, so I'm happy about that. So stall room. Strong room is a very strong enchanted ice where not weapons, apparels. Oh, excuse me. Where basically it's only found here. You can craft it, but you have to have ebony crafting to craft it. I don't have that. I was lucky enough to buy this one. But it's a very strong ice. The only thing that could pick at it is not a normal pickaxe, but an ancient Nordic pickaxe. This special pickaxe. I got like two or three right now. So basically, I was able to get a lot of it. I still need to gain some smithing. But other than that, no big deal. We got a bunch of cool new weapons, like a bunch of dwarven stuff. Dwarven bolts, so now I need to find a crossbow. Got some ebony arrows, ebony bow. This has been my new weapon lately. And you're probably wondering, what happened to the scimitar? Well, the scimitar wasn't as good as this whatsoever. So I decided to let go of the scimitar for space, because it was carrying me down. I got some glass bows, elven stuff. I've gone through a lot of changes. And I'll go to my house and I'll show you what I got. But I did a lot of stuff. Look at that Nordic shield. I think that's one of the coolest things ever. But another thing I've been working on is spell casting and just other stuff like that. So it's been a heck of a journey, I'll tell you that. There's a lot of things in here. There was a lot, and I'm so upset that you guys don't get to see it, you know? Because there was a lot of cool things. A lot of me screaming, a lot of me complaining, a lot of me just getting frustrated and dying. And I know you've seen that before, but it was one of the things where I was like, oh man, you know, I really wish I could have saved that. Because now you see this, you're like, oh man, I must have missed a lot. Yeah, you missed a lot. You missed a lot. Like, I'll tell you right now, I spent a lot of time in the wee hours of the morning. In the wee hours of the morning, doing this. Like, a couple nights ago, I think I played this game from 7 or 8 o'clock at night to 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning. So 12 hours of straight doing this. No breaks, but I would stop the recording, so I'd make hour increments of recording. So, like, I would take 2 or 3 hours and then stop, upload the game again, take 2 hours, stop, upload the game again, and so on and so forth. So some of the things we've, why is that like that? Are you coming this way? Anyways, guess not. So we gotten a lot of stuff. So we've gotten some Nordic weapons, which to me, if only they were stronger, I would use them more. Dwarven armor, see, I got that. This is an enchanted chest and some pretty cool boots, I think. I don't remember if... No, I don't put the boots on there. Look, and so you've seen the guards outside with their cool bone stuff like that. I got some of that, too. Nordic Warhammer, that's a beast and a half. Nordic War Axe. Why are they like that? So, I don't know why they're standing like that. They should be, like, facing like that. But they're, not. Anyways, so this is a Thalmor hood. I found a Thalmor trying to kill some elves, doing a mission for... finding the Stalrim source. This is Mirak. I wish you would turn around, but he was the other Dragonborn. And he had this power where he could spew out poisonous stuff and vines and all that with the staff. And he has this cool looking sword that did the same thing that constantly moves. So he was a bad guy I had to fight. You were a pain in the butt this whole time. But I got your stuff, so I'm not complaining. Let's see, what else can I show you? Got a lot of weapons too, so. Ebony sword, more Nordic stuff, ebony gauntlets. We're getting really into the ebony stuff, and I dropped off a lot of stuff. We killed a lot of dragons, found a lot of gems and money. Like, look at my money, it's 14,038, whatever the currency is called. We'll just say gold. But there's a lot of things I got, a lot of things I seen and did, and it was just a handful and a half. Look at that, that's horror frost. Oh yeah, the Chitlin armor. So the Chitlin armor was the thing I used for a while because it was one of my strongest. Ooh, I could put... Why is that in there? Oh yeah, because I have the other one. So Azildia's stuff, you find that going through... What is it called? Remember the mine thing I was telling you where I paid the guy to excavate? Yeah, so you find cool things, and every time you keep paying him, he keeps unlocking stuff so you can keep trying to get it. And that's what I'm wearing right now, so like... I got, so it's called Azido. I could be pronouncing it wrong, and if I am, well, that's your fault. I don't care. But there's like, I got his armor on right now, and I got some Chitlin braces, so my attacks are better. Yeah, so I've been getting a lot of stuff, and it's been really cool. Let me show you some other stuff I got. So this is my new house. I even have like a little safe over here. Look at the little safe. Maybe I should really put my jewelry in there, but don't care. Alright, so basically the way I got this house, there were some assassins. They're trying to kill the king of this place. They're from another evil place. And long story short, I killed them. Why is there a basket on? Oh, okay. Get the basket off. Get the basket off! Get off my thing. Anyways. So like I said, like I got some cool things. There's another ancient Nordic pickaxe. I thought they were rare. Apparently there's a couple more in the game. Another ebony sword. Staff of Fury. Another Nordic shield, because why not? Decoration. Staff of Familiar. Staff of Calm. Staff of Reanimation. Spare bedroom with some food stuff. And Asham and whatever that's called. Thing. Anyway. This is probably my favorite part in the whole thing. the training area and smithing area. So I got a lot of cool weapons. So, like, here's my blade sword that I got from the blade lady. Even though it's a cool sword, like a cool katana-looking sword, I really don't use it because it's not as powerful. And then the blood skull blade. Who was it? It was... Oh, yeah, so basically I went... So this town is famous for an ebony mine. And long story short, the guy, the old guy who was running it, didn't want to go down there because it was too dangerous. And he said his father was killed down there, but the company that said that he was dead died for a different reason than he did. He didn't believe him, so he sent me down there, and it was because he was going after this, which I got. This, I killed the general who had the Ashbon thing, and that thing, if I ever become a two-handed warrior, would probably be my weapon of choice. So I got a smelter, a forge, and my own place. Nordic battle axe, that's pretty cool. And then Elven Mesa, whatever that is. Oh yeah, so now let me introduce... We're going to go outside, and I'll introduce you to the crew. So you're probably wondering, you know, hey, you last had Lydia. Whatever happened to Lydia? Well, I will tell you what happened to Lydia. So I forgot. I completely forgot that the people that follow you can actually die. I know that when they get really hurt, they'll go on, like, one knee or whatever, and they'll just regenerate their life. But I really, honestly, truly forgot. Oh, hold on one second.
Who's that?
Whoa. You were supposed to be cleared. Alright, well, you get some action. These are the Ashbon. And long story short, they're a pain in the butt. But they drop down some cool things. So when you search them, they have ore, and they have jewelry. So usually, you know what, I'll take that. So are you dead yet? No, you're not dead. So long story short, we were fighting the guy in these Ashbon. Now, these Ashbon are really hard to fight. Oh, look, you paralyzed because of my armor, yeah. Search Ashbon. Ooh, ebony ore. That was cool. So, yeah, long story short, these people are really hard to fight. They're really powerful. And at the time, I was really weak. So, while we were fighting the final battle, there was three of those guys all at once.
All makeup, protect me.
What? Yeah. Let me see. Magic, magic, magic. There.
I do not fear death.
You don't fear death? Well, I don't feel like killing you right now, but long story short, I'll go in here and show you what happened. So we were fighting those three, and then the main guy. And the main guy is, in a handbasket. Which means he was incredibly tough, if you don't understand. I'm like, whew. And long story short, there's Lydia. I'm actually going to take those now. Let's see. Expander. Yeah, so long story short, she passed away. I thought she was just down and I was fighting these things by myself. And that wasn't the case. So when I finished off everything... Oh, the guy's gone now. And when I finished off everything, I realized, oh crap, she's dead. She had all my things and I was worried that, you know, now that she's dead, I wasn't going to get everything. Well, that wasn't the case. I literally just kept fast traveling there and fast traveling back. And kept dropping off stuff at my house. I think I had the house at that time. No, I didn't have the house at the time. I was gaining the house, I think. Yeah, I was gaining the house. So I was just really mad that she died right there. And then, like, the next mission I did, I gained the house. So I was like, oh, crap. So basically, I ran back to see if she was body was still there. It was. And I kept traveling back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And kept transporting the stuff. But yeah. So there's a lot of mines you can dig at. There's a lot of cool things you can do. And I'll probably come back here and do some more cool things. Because I think there's another mission I was supposed to do here. I'm not so sure. Oh, yeah. I got to, like, gain up level to go to here and get the monies. But other than that, it's a really cool place. Really cool DLC. Like I told you, I spent many, many, many hours. Which would have... If to a normal person who played this, like, an hour or two a day, would have been here... for like a good couple of weeks, so it would have been good, worthwhile doing everything. But long story short, I did a lot of things, saved some people, became a king of steroid psychopathic smurfs, and now I'm here. Oh, and I forgot to mention, when I came back, after I met the Blades person, I was supposed to do a mission for her. I was supposed to go here and go find out where the dragon burial site is and what's happening. So I did that, found out that the main dragon, who, if you know the story mode, I forgot his name right now, was resurrecting them with a call. So basically, he resurrected the dragon in front of us, we destroyed it, and the lady was like, alright, I truly believe you're the dragonborn. I was like, yeah, I know I'm the dragonborn, live with it. And here we are. Oh, so yeah, Freya. Let me talk about the dwarf, this guy and Freya. So Freya, basically after Lydia died, I was like, man, I really need someone to help carry stuff and help fight for me. And of course, before I knew I could get Freya, I saw this assassin guy hanging out in the bar of Ravenrock. And you'll probably see him later on, but the reason why I don't use him anymore is because he was freaking annoying he was a great fighter, don't get me wrong. I would fight with him every day, but he just kept saying, anytime you want to go to Skyrim, I spent here worth a lifetime. I'm like, yeah, I don't care.
I don't think you were followed. Come on, I have a plan.
Alright, we'll go. I'll follow you. So long story short, after saving the people and doing the very last mission killing Mirok, I was talking to Freya, just trying to see if there's any other missions around town, and it came to the point where I was like, oh, I could talk to her into joining me. And so she did. So I'm going to pause right here. So also, in the game, in the other area, you can, there's a dwarven thing that you can start unlocking things.
How we're going to get you into the Thalmor embassy.
I'll tell you later. You're not coming.
That would be a bad idea. I'd be what? Too likely to attract the wrong kind of attention. But they don't know you at all yet.
Oh. So what's your plan? How do I infiltrate the Thalmor embassy?
Thalmor ambassador. I can get you into one of those parties.
Oh.
I have a contact inside the embassy.
Oh, I remember
He's
the
not
party.
A, his name is Malborn. I'll get... While you're doing that, meet me at the Solitude Stables after you've arranged things with Malborn. Any questions?
How am I going to get into
Let
the party?
That. You'll have a real invitation, don't worry. As long as you can act the part of a Thalmor toady, you'll get past the guard. Sounds good. Be careful.
Alright. Anyway, so... Long story short... Are you...
What?
Gonna move?
Something
no, not you. No, I'm just... getting him out of the way. Steal arrows. Anyway, so... I knew the dwarven stuff was really popular, here. But I didn't know how popular it was gonna be over on the other side until I realized there's a lot, and I mean a lot. Oh, chest. Yeah, because that's where you keep your armor, isn't it? Anything here? No. Yeah, so that's... Oops, sorry. Anyway, sorry. I get easily distracted. I severely apologize for that. But, so there's some dwarven things, and then in one of the dwarven mines... let me go show you what these are. You find these things and while doing searches and all that. And every time you do a search, you get to fight off these people, but you can gain a little buddy. So my problem was, the first little buddy I got, he was a spider, a dwarven spider. He was a cute little guy, and I was like, oh man, he seemed real friendly. But my first reaction was, oh crap, another spider, got to fight him off. I thought it was a trap. And I killed him.
What? Something you're still confused about?
No, I'm not confused. I'm just wondering why you're still talking. Anyways, let's see, where do I need to go? All the way over there. So, we'll start right here. Anyway, so I accidentally killed him. And I didn't know he was good until later on because I had another key or another one of those stones. And I was like, alright, well, I'll just go and do this one now. And long story short, when I opened up the other thing, I was like, oh crap, another one of these guys. It said Steadfast Dwarven Spear. And he's a cute dude. I named him Barry. I named him Barry. Barry seems like a cool guy. Anyway, so long story short again. I keep saying long story short. Well, it is long story short. Oh, and here's my favorite part of the whole thing. I can walk on water now because of these boots. Boo to the yah. So when I finally saw him, I was like, oh, you seem friendly. And I was talking with him because I could talk with him. So I was like, well, I'd never talked to one of these things before. Oh, you're that guy. Oh, another crab. Let's go. So it said he was friendly, and then I said, and then I gave me a chunk. What? Oh yeah. So let me get my magic out. It's not destruction. Oh. I'll defeat you single-handed. There we go. And so I said I could bring him along with me, and so I said sure. And I was wondering if that means the other guy, the mercenary assassin guy that I picked up, was not going to follow anymore. Well, that wasn't the case. And so I had two guys at once. And I still have two guys at once. I probably could get three if I really wanted to. But sometimes it gets a little bit handful. I like having the dwarven guy because even though he can't carry anything, he's always quick to go into a fight, quick to go into battle. So it's always a nice thing to see. Shut up, Ninroot. Oh, look at a little deer. And let me see where I am on the map. I gotta go here. Yeah. So even though he can't carry anything, he's a great fighter, and I like having him on my team. And then Freya, who is also another great fighter, I like having her because she can also carry stuff. And the other guy, you know, he was really good. He was a really good fighter, and he always would summon this flame Antioch, I think it was called, which was really, really helpful, especially against when there was a lot of people against us. As much as I loved him, he just got really annoying, and I got really, really sick of hearing from him and talking to him. And maybe one day I'll bring him back to Skyrim. Maybe next episode I'll bring him back to Skyrim. I don't know. And then just let him go like that. But he was a cool guy. Or a good fighter. But, thought that was something. I'm walking on water. But yeah, so those two are my compadres. I love them to death. Now it's time to go to Solitude and meet another Melbourne with his name. But Solitude was the place. Let's run. But yeah, so there's a lot that happened. And I know I'm talking and you're probably like, oh, this seems a little crazy. This seems a little like I'm lost. Well, I'm sorry that you're lost. You have every right to be lost. I wish I could have made this a lot easier for you guys. Like I said, when all the recordings were ended up bad and I had it and all that other stuff like that, I was upset. Because I messed around with settings and I probably shouldn't have, but I did. So, anyways, it was a heartbreaking moment. You missed all the cool stuff and a lot of the fighting and a lot of the fights were really the cool part. I think I also got to mention
dragons breathing fire in the sky, vampires brazenly attacking people on the street. It's the end of the world, I tell you.
It's only the end because you suck. Anyways, oh, I almost forgot to tell you, I rode a dragon. Yeah, in one of the games, or when you unlock, in one of the final parts when you fight Murat, you unlock a shout called Bend Will. And when you get to the last one, you can control a dragon. And part of the mission is you have to control the dragon. The dragon fights for you.
Hmm? Some say I got my position because my cousin is the Emperor. Nonsense.
Probably.
The man's given me nothing. He can't even be bothered to attend my training.
So I rode a dragon. That was cool. Werebears.
If you've come to Solitude to join the Legion, speak to Ricker.
I haven't.
Just keep your nose clean while you're here, or you'll end up like Rohan.
Keep your nose clean while you're here. Oh, brown nosing. Oh, I get you.